Let me show you how to use and take full advantage of your Jotform Sign mobile app. So let's get started. Welcome to Jotform. My name is George, and on this video, I'm going to show you how to take full advantage of your Jotform Sign mobile app. Luckily, I already have this installed on my phone, and I'm going to show you how to use it right away. Now, don't forget to sign up right now. You can go ahead and use the free e-signature software and use the mobile app for free too. So let's get started. Let me go ahead and grab my phone, and we are going to get started with the Jotform Sign application. Now, in this case, I already have it installed. Just go ahead and jump into your iOS or Android store and download it right away. It's called Jotform Sign. We're going to go ahead and open up the app, and we're going to get started with this. So first thing we need to do is obviously logged in, which I've already done. And we're going to get started by adding our own signature. I can go ahead and draw or type in my signature. In this case, I am going to draw, and I'm going to make a signature right here. So I am done. Let's go ahead and continue. My initials, JA, which is fine. I can go ahead and change this if I like, but it's fine. And I can go ahead and get started by signing the document, request signatures, and I can view every single document that I've previously created in my Jotform Sign account. Now, the first thing I want to show you is how to self-sign a document. So we're going to click on the green plus button in the bottom, and I'm going to use the self-sign option. So let's go ahead and select this, and we can go ahead and upload a document or scan a document. And this is where the fun part starts. I'm going to get started by scanning a document. So right now on my desk, I have a document that I want to use to scan. So let's go ahead and scan the document. Here we go. Let's go ahead and scan our document. It automatically locates the document, so it knows the designated areas. I don't have to manually select this, and I can go ahead and enhance. I can use filters if I need to. So if I want to use the color one, in this case, there's no color. The grayscale, black and white. But in this case, I'm going to use black and white, which I think is going to look the clearest. That way, I'm not going to get any shadows from my hand when I scan this document. So let's go ahead and apply this here. I also have the option to crop and rotate. In this case, the crop and rotation is fine, but in case it grabbed a piece of the table, in case it grabbed my fingers when I'm holding the document here, I can go ahead and remove that by cropping. In this case, I'm good to go. No need for cropping, okay? So I also have the option for clean in case I need to clean this up, but I'm good to go. I can add a brand new document by clicking on the little plus sign right here, and again, scanning a new document. In this case, I only need this page, so we're good to go. Let's hit next. I can now add a new document to this too, in case I didn't add it before, but let's go ahead and click next because we're good to go. Here we go. Now I have the option to add elements into this document. So in this case, I am one of the signers, so I'll go ahead and add a signature down here. I'm gonna add it here. I can go ahead and resize this, and I'm going to do so right now. Here we go. Let's go ahead and select outside. Let's add a new element here. I'll add initials, and I'll add this right on this side. Again, I'm going to resize this, make it a little bit smaller. Let's click outside. Here we go. We can add more elements like the name, email, text, phone number, and just add the elements that you are going to need. Okay. So in this case, this is a self-sign. So I'll be good to go. Let's go ahead and sign this. Let's start signing. Here's my signature already from the one that we added in the beginning. Let's go ahead and finish, accept and sign, and we should be good to go. Here we go, that document is now signed. So right now, wherever I am, I can just go ahead and scan a document, e-sign it, and I'll be good to go. Okay, I can go ahead and share it now, I can download it, or I can go ahead and close this if I'm good to go. Now, that is for the self-sign feature. What if I want to have an in-person e-signature? Well, that is possible too. Let's go ahead and click on the plus button, invite to sign. And again, I have three options. I can go ahead and upload a document, scan a document, or use one of my previous documents. In this case, let's use the My Documents feature, and I have a few documents here available. And I'm gonna use this one down here, a residential lease agreement, okay? So this one already has the elements that I'm gonna need to fill out, so it makes things much easier. But I can go ahead and add elements if I think that they are missing. So again, just go ahead and add an element, and we can go ahead and select the signer here. In this case, we have three signers, okay? In case we need a brand new signer, go ahead and click on add signer and add their details. Let's hit enter, and now I have a fourth signer. In this case, I am going to delete this, and I'm also going to delete the third one. I'm just going to keep two for testing purposes. And again, we have elements that we can start adding right away. Okay, so now we have two signers in this document. Let's hit next. Now we have two options here. Send to sign. That is not what we want right now. What we want to do is an in-person sign. So I'm going to select this. Okay, then I have the option to sign in order. That means that I can select who is going to sign first. In this case, I'm going to enable this, and now I have the option to move these. So if I go ahead and select it, I can go ahead and move the signer if I need to. But in this case, I'm going to leave it as it is. Let's go ahead and add the name. In this case, just keeping it simple. Here we go. I'm going to add a test email, test.com. Here we go. And for the signer too, which is me, it's fine. We already have the details there. I can add a note and I can say, please sign the document. Okay. So we're good to go. Let's start to sign. Should be loading up in a few seconds. We are good to go. I'm going to go ahead and start signing. And in this case, it's enabling us to type in the details that are needed. In this case, I'm going to try to skip all of this right now. There's 134 sections to fill out. And that's because this is a long document with a lot of elements. So give me a few seconds. Here we go. We are at the signature section. So first off, we have the date. In this case, it's already set by default to today's date, but you can change the date here if you need to. Let's hit next, print name. In this case, it's for him. Let's hit next. The signature that I'm going to do in person. Again, let's hit next. Here we go. Short text in case we need to add that there. That is my signature. So we have the in-person signature and then it's my signature. Let's hit next. For the details, I'm good to go. Let's accept and sign. We have now ran the e-signature in person. So that's a pretty useful feature that you can start using right away by having the mobile application. Again, let's hit close. And then we have several features here in the application in general. We'll be able to view all the documents that we have here previously. For example, let me go ahead and view this one. I have all the available signers here, which is two people. I can go ahead and cancel the request straight from here and set an explanation why. I'm not gonna do that, but it just shows you that is possible. We have a few filters here available. We have the search bar to start searching for your documents in case you have several documents available. Then you have my documents. So in case you just wanna preview the documents, you don't want to go through the process of actually signing, then you can go ahead and view them in my signed documents. We can go ahead and preview here. We can go ahead and invite to sign, edit the document, preview, download, rename, delete, etc., all from here. So several features available here on the Jotform Sign mobile application. You can definitely take full advantage of this application right now by downloading it in your mobile app store and start using it right away. It's gonna help you with all your document needs straight from the mobile application. Now, best of all, you'll have access to these documents from your phone and from your Jotform desktop. So you'll have full access to customize and start working with these documents that are gonna help you really take full advantage of the mobile application. Well, I thank you all for watching. Please let me know here in the comments what you think about the mobile application from Jotform Sign and what you would like to see in the future. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell to get notifications when new videos come out. And that is a wrap.